वेलकम टू श्री जी एम डोंडा प्राइमरी स्कूल। आई एम रानी मेरी पंचाल। गुड मॉर्निंग टू वन एंड ऑल। हाउ आर यू ऑल? होप फाइन। टुडे इन सोशल साइंस सेशन वी विल स्टडी चैप्टर नंबर 7, गुजरात लोकेशन बाउंड्री एंड फिजियोग्राफी। चिल्ड्रेन, यू ऑल हैव स्टडीड अबाउट योर डिस्ट्रिक्ट in class 5th, yes? Now, we will study about your state, Gujarat. So, can you see the map of India and there Gujarat? Yes, it's in western part of India. Yes, Gujarat is located in western part of India. Now, the state of Gujarat is located in the western part of India. It is flanked by the Arabian Sea. Now, flanked means what? Surrounded, okay, or be on each one side of something. Yes, the state of Gujarat lies between 20.06 north latitude and 24.42 north latitude. Similarly, it lies between 68.10 east longitude and 74.28 east longitude. So now we will study boundaries of Gujarat. So Gujarat has two types of boundaries: sea boundary and land boundary. So children, now open the textbook page number 36. Are you ready? No children with the textbook? Yes. So page number 36, you can write down the land boundary and sea boundary. The blanks are given. Yes, but see children, check your textbook page number 36. The fill in the blanks are given. In that, land boundary is given. Yes or no? Shall I read from the textbook? Look at the map and answer the following questions. So, the fill in the blanks are given. Okay. Listen carefully and write. Fine. So, the first one is Madhya Pradesh is in the east. Please write in your textbook. Madhya Pradesh is in the east. This is land boundary. Now, next is Arabian Sea is in the west. Now see children, Arabian Sea is in the west. Okay, so Arabian Sea is sea boundary. Okay, it's not in the textbook, but I have mentioned in this bracket, it's sea boundary, it's not land boundary. Fine. So please you also note down in your textbook, Arabian Sea is sea boundary. Fine. Next one, Rajasthan is in the north, that is land boundary. Maharashtra in the south, land boundary. Next is Pakistan in the northwest. Got it children? So these blanks will be asked in your exams. So please write in your textbook page number 36, the blanks are given. Now I'll explain you in briefly. So, here the boundaries are sea boundary and land boundary. Now, first one is Madhya Pradesh is in the east. I'll show you in the map where is Madhya Pradesh. Okay, it is in the east. See the arrow, children, Madhya Pradesh. Arabian Sea in the west, it's a sea boundary. Rajasthan in the north, Maharashtra in the south, Pakistan in the northwest. Got it, my dear students? So, now as we have learned, the sea boundary, Arabian Sea lies in the west of Gujarat. Yes. So this sea boundary is about 1600 kilometer long. There are Gulf of Kutch and Gulf of Khambhat. I'll show you, children. Okay, so there are Gulf of, first we will see the Arabian Sea. Okay, now I'll show you the Gulf of Kutch and Gulf of Khambhat. See, this is Gulf of Kutch and this is Gulf of Khambhat. Got it, my dear students? Yes. Now next we are going to study expansion. The north-south of Gujarat is about 590 kilometers, while the east-west is about 500 kilometers. Gujarat has a geographical area of about 196,024 square kilometer, which is about 6% of the total India. Indian territory. Okay, Gujarat is largest state in area in India. The land area of Gujarat are divided into four parts. North Gujarat. See, children, here is Banaskantha, Mehsana, Patan and all. South Gujarat. Here you will see Bharuch, Narmada, Surat, Tapi and all. Central Gujarat. Yes, right. Saurashtra, Kutch. Okay, so now we will study physiography. There are five physiography divisions of Gujarat: plains, hilly and mountain areas, plateaus, deserts, coastal plains, right? So we will study, children. First we will study plains. So the major part of Gujarat consists of plains. Rivers flowing through the plains of Gujarat have deposited alluvium. So these plains are made up of alluvial soil. And so the plains of Gujarat are very fertile. You can see in this picture, the plain of South and Central Gujarat is more fertile as these plains have enough facilities for agriculture and for settlements. There is large population. Most of the North Gujarat is plain region. Now we'll study hilly and mountainous areas. The hills and mountains are divided into three regions: Tal Gujarat Hills, Saurashtra Hills, Kutch Hills. Now here, see, Tal Gujarat Hills means the hilly region which prevails over entire eastern boundary from Banaskantha to Valsad is known as Aravali Range. This range include Gabbar Hill, Taranga Hill, Idar Hill, Pavagadh Hill, Rajpipla Hills, Parnera Hills near Valsad and Saputara Hills. Now next is Saurashtra Hills. I have put the picture, children. The central hilly region of Saurashtra includes Chotila Hill, Bardo Hill near Porbandar, Shetrunjo Hill near Palitana and Kokra Hill in the north of Bhavnagar. Now Kutch Hills. The hills of Kutch Gujarat Hills are Dinodar, Karo, Bhujio, Lilio, Kankot Hills, etc. are the Kutch Hills. Okay, they are. Now we will study plateaus. Now, plateaus are landforms which are higher than the sea level and are flat like plains in the upper part. In Gujarat, central Kutch and central Saurashtra are known as plateau. The Saurashtra plateau is higher in its central part and becomes lower towards the sea coast. Now we will study the deserts. The deserts of Kutch are sandy but full of salt, saline. You know, the first picture, the white color, okay, that is Kutch Desert. On a moonlight night, the area looks like a white bed cover. You can see, children. Yes? Now we will study coastal plains. So, Arabian Sea is situated to the west of Gujarat. This coastal boundary is about 1,600 kilometers long. Two gulfs in the Arabian Sea, Gulf of Kutch and Gulf of Khambat, and which is very useful for international trade. Okay, so children, I hope you have understood this chapter. So thank you for watching. Understand, read the lesson from the textbook and do the exercises and learn all the exercises from the workbook. Children, stay safe. Bye bye. See you.